My life be like, ooh, yeah, ooh. My life be like, ooh, yeah, ooh.
The green is up from the start line. Marshall, it's down, we're away and racing. Summerwood and Isabella Stansmore-Wilson both make good starts to Stansmore-Wilson. Chops to the inside to defend off the advances of Jared Fox Whiteley in the Oakley. Looks like all 31 runners have made their way round the National Loop successfully. And Stansmore Wilson in the 88 is going to try and follow Summerwood in the Sol Micro Max through. Moved to third place there, holding to the inside of Thomas Potter. They're side by side down the back straight. Potter's going to have the run there with Jared Fox Whiteley. Gets the nose down the inside of Stansmore Wilson. Contact between the two of those. Wilson keeps the foot in. We know that she's not shy, and it's opened the door for the 38 of Thomas Potter. And Jared Fox Whiteley, in going for the lead, now finds himself down in third place.
Wow. Amazing job taking down the line. He's holding her line.
As such, and this is the beat that you can't touch. I told you, homeboy. Can't touch this.
7 as the 29 of Summerwood moves out at the head of the field. The gap is 3/10, and Tom Potter's come through as well. Leon Barlow has got past Jared Fox Whiteley. Fox Whiteley, though, back to the inside. He's going to.
Forget it like that, so you know you want to dance.
And Barlow with Summerwood, the Sol Micro Max, out at the head of the field.
And this is the you can't touch. Yo, I told you. You
can't for touch. The field to come through, you can see the dejection as her head drops in the seat. And now it's a three-cart race between Holden, Potter, and Fox Whiteley. Potter comes through. Jared Fox Whiteley pushes Thomas Potter through into the lead and makes the move himself down into hairpin number three. Two corners remaining. As they go into hairpin four, Holden comes back to Fox Whiteley. Fox Whiteley will go side by side. Thomas Potter, he will come through and win heat number one for the Honda Cadets. Fox Whiteley in second, Holden.
Break it down. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Here come the hot stuff. On the lyrical gangsta. Pick up the cool in the area. Still love it like that. Here come the hot stuff. On the lyrical gangsta. Excuse me, Mr. Officer. Still love it like that. Na 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 na.
Wind is down. We're away and racing. It's a fantastic start. From the 42 of Leon Barlow, has put Summerwood on the front row in the Micro Max, has dropped down into the middle of the pack, and from fifth place, Jared Fox get the switch back. It's just placed into the hands of Jared Fox Whiteley, and now Summerwood in the 29 in the Sol Micro Max has got some work to do, and this is the first time we're going to have to see her try and race her way through the pack. First in heat, she just moved out the front. Tom Potter, dive box down the inside of hairpin number three. Behind them, that's Lewis Goff in the early day. That was 3-10 for the final. The next two laps to sort out the trophy. At the end of the day, Tom Potter goes to the inside. Two race wins so far for him today. Would like to make it 3 from 3, having broken the outright lap record in heat number two, which was set in qualifying by Isabella Stansmore Wilson. He only gets to hold it for half a day. Tom Potter, 47.438, the new lap record. Takes it by less than half a tenth from Stansmore Wilson. They're now going to come over the line. Great Fox Whiteley's on the inside. He's going to have track position. Moves across, and Thomas Potter's going to come down the inside of Tom Holden as well, is he? Holden's going to try and close the door. Thomas Potter down the inside, contact between the two of them. They both end up in the right direction though, so no harm done. Between those two, they're nose to tail, they make their way through the traffic. And with two remaining now, there's clear track in front of the five leaders. It's Fox Whiteley, Holden, Potter, Barlow, and Summerwood in fifth place. Sticking with the Hunters in front, but still can't find a way past them. The group in front as they jockey for position.
Absolutely great line. Oh wow, look at that. Absolutely amazing move. gonna fall off, and yes, yes, Thomas Holden wants to be.
Holden Sue, they're side by side down the back straight. Tom Potter's going to come from the inside. They're going to go three wide. That's NASCAR style round the south back corner. There's contact between Holden and Fox Whiteley. Potter Sue as well, and Tom Holden drops from first down into third place. Tom Potter to the inside. Can he make it two for two on the corners? They're going to be three wide as well on the corner. Fox Whiteley chops across the bows of the number 38 over the line. Last lap then, 4 hour Honda Cadet class.
Let's see if Whiteley can hold it off, because so far in the last couple of laps it's been absolutely crazy.
This is the corner where we've seen all of the overtakes. Can anybody do anything? Leon Barlow can. Ooh. From fourth, up into third place at the expense of Holden. One lap ago he was leading, now he's down in fourth. Summer Wood's going to try and get past as well. Fox Whiteley opens the door. Didn't think he was close enough, but yes he is.
Who's taking the inside again?
Let's see if comes through. There's contact between the two of them. Fox Whiteley's round the hairpin number three.
Thomas Potter.
Fox Whiteley tried to make the move, couldn't get the job done. Down the inside though. Thomas Potter, three from three for him from Barlow and Holden. Fox Whiteley will come through in fourth place. Bangs the steering wheel as he comes over as well. A phenomenal sixth. We missed that with all the front action going on. Absolutely amazing from her up into sixth. Rise, we're away in racing. It's a great start from Holden on the outside, but is he going to get balked? They're going to go three wide, and Jaron Fox Whiteley's going to come through as well from fifth place down the inside. Bounces across the grass on the inside, drops a wheel off the circuit, but manages to get back going again. Fox Whiteley with a great start. Summer Wood.
Blood like ice, one look could kill my pain. You're three.
From the outside of the front row with Thomas Potter. From pole position is really, really struggling. Wood fails to get drive out of hairpin number one. That's Fort Fox Whiteley. And Thomas Potter's got back. Wood's going to come down the inside. They're three wide down the back straight towards the south bank through the extra power of the Micro Mac. And it's pulling Jaron Fox Whiteley along with her as well. Tom Holden's going to get hung out to drive around the outside. As you know, he keeps his foot in. And Thomas Potter as well, out of nowhere, has come back. He's been in every place from first to fifth, back up into third on the opening lap. Both of the Adrians there, side by side as they come through. Ben and Melissa there, one in the blue helmet, one in the red. They come over the line with Ben Adrian just in front of Melissa. So Summer Wood, Holden, Fox Whiteley, Potter, Barlow, Ben Adrian, Melissa Adrian, Goff, Fordy and Larry Price, the top 10 as they come through. Start our Honda Cadet class.
Excited.
In the background, both Ben and Melissa Adrian are in the mix. Thomas Potter makes a late move down the inside of Leon Barlow there in the red and yellow livery car. He's going to drop down into fourth place. Drop behind the Morris Lubricant livery number 38 with the green helmet, Tom Potter. Barlow tried to return the favour back down inside hairpin three, but Potter closed the door. Six remaining, we're not even at half race distance yet. Very, very soon, four laps remaining. Tom Potter comes through, 47, 3, 2, 6. A new lap record once again, smashed by Thomas Potter. 47, 3, 2, 6. He smashed it once already today. He goes again, there they go into the corner. They're slightly wide into hairpin one. Potter's through on the inside of Tom Holden. He's the driver on the move. The timesheets say so. He's going to try and get down the inside of Holden as these drivers don't continue to battle it out. Look who's got two or three cart lengths now. Fox Whiteley in the lead with a comfortable two or three cart lengths. By comfortable, I mean that.
The extra bit of...
Yeah, very much so, because he's not had that all day, has he? But now he's going to come over the line. Potter comes through over the line as well. Is there anything he can do about Jaron Fox Whiteley? Battle it out, way. Anthony Potter goes to the inside there with Mason Webster. Split the back marker. Jared Fox Whiteley, though, still has a gap of 4 or 5 cart lengths. He will see the last lap board next time he comes round. He's been given a little bit of respite by Thomas Potter, Tom Holden, and Leon Barlow fighting this one out.
Holden is pushing.
Yeah, exactly. But Thomas Potter, who's been arguably the fastest driver, the timesheets say so, with the fastest lap throughout the day, may have to settle for second place here because he's been too busy battling with Tom Holden. But Jared Fox Whiteley's got enough time to look over his shoulder and see that he's got a comfortable gap of 4 or 5 cart lengths, which is far more than what he's had all day. The last lap board will await them then as they come over the start finish line this time round. And behind them, it's going to be 4 carts and 3 podium places, with Fox Whiteley, Potter, Barlow, and Adrian all coming through. In front of them, Summer Wood continues to lead overall in the micro match. The track in front of them is clear. Doesn't look like we're going to see any back markers.
No.
In this link, there's Holden. Ooh. Goes to the inside of Thomas
Potter.
Very
good. Oh, double overtake.
Slides down the inside, up into second. Then Potter defends to the inside. Will that hold Holden on the way out? Can Barlow snatch the final step on the podium? The battle is now for second place and third, because it's just handing the victory now to Jared Fox Whiteley, who's driven superbly. Leon Barlow down the inside, carries too much speed right into the back of Thomas Potter. Problems for Potter, it looks like. Barlow's going to come through side by side over the start.
Wow.
Who's going to get the final step on the podium? Holden, I think, holds on for the final step on the podium from Leon Barlow.
Friends.